Hi there, the countdown is on to MTV's coverage of the most important event on the metal calendar, Donington 96. So join me in just a little while for interviews and live performances from all the bands on the bill. The festivities here are headlined by Ozzy Osbourne and Kiss. It's a beautiful sunny day. There's a ton of great metal going down, so stick around. Headbangers Ball from Donington 96 coming up next. Not to be missed.
These young people are writing a story based on their game of sword and sorcery. Tell Beavis and Butthead about your character, Una.
Okay. I'm an elven cleric named Glendal. I have 2 ruined stones and a druid ring I found in an orc stronghold. I have 12 hit points and a charmed long staff and a cloak of invisibility.
Hey, Beavis. I got a charmed long staff. Whoa. Scummy people.
Yeah, scummy people are cool.
Slimy people.
Yeah, slimy people rule. Yeah. I think that's like, words and stuff.
Watching. Oh, yeah.
Check it out, Beavis. It's one of those lavatory retrievers.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, Butthead. How come, like, when you go to the dentist, sometimes they call the bathroom the laboratory?
I don't know.
Maybe it's because, like, that's where the dentist goes when he inspects your nads.
Your dentist inspects your nads?
Yeah, yeah.
Welcome down to the most important event on the metal calendar, Donington 1996. Well, as you can see, it's a glorious day here. There are 2 stages on the go all day, and of course, the festivities are headlined here by Ozzy Osbourne, who's on stage in the background there, and of course, Kiss, playing here in the original lineup form for the first time in 17 years. So that just says what a special occasion it really is down here at Donington. So we're going to be bringing you all the action from both stages, interviews, live performances. It's a great, great lineup, a great day, and you can enjoy it all right here on Headbangers Ball from Donington 1996.
Stops. When the whispers flare, the buses drive hard, but there are still rubbers off to a death entrance. As I walk in front with the black girl, my mom is not to bring her around, cause she's black. My family would put her down. I bring the white dress ties to my turn up so pure. But hey, so she said, get the fact that I don't look like you. She said, you're possessed with a power bigger than the bed. Yeah, power bigger than the bed. She said,
but you're stuck here alone. She said, you're possessed with a power bigger than the pain. Power bigger than the pain. Power bigger than the pain. Heart by Donald Trump.
Yes, Headbangers Ball is coming to you from the metal event of the year, Donington 96. And we're going to sparkle and hopefully not fade too much right now with Everclear. And it's a great pleasure to meet you guys.
I get my shades on. I get my shades on too. Hi, I'm Art.
I'm Craig.
And I'm Greg.
And it's lovely to meet you. First of all, I just want to say Sparkle and Fade is one of my favorite albums of the year. And I'm so pleased for all the success you've been having in America. But we're going to talk about that in a minute. But you've actually just come off stage getting the Kiss vibe here. Well, no, Headbangers Ball is here. That's all you need to know. But listen, how did it go today on stage at Donington on the Kerrang stage?
We banged our heads really hard.
It started kind of slow because we walked off the plane, literally got on the bus, came here, got off the bus, got on stage, and our amps didn't work. My amp didn't work.
His amp kept blowing up.
And so it was a tense moment there at the beginning.
But we rocked on after that.
We borrowed Korn's amp without them knowing about it.
Don't tell them.
And then everything was beautiful.
Excellent. Well, great. And how does it feel to actually be playing at probably the most prestigious metal event in the world? Had you heard about it before you came here?
Oh, yes.
But of course, Donington. Where's the castle?
It's a little tiny one way over there somewhere.
Oh, really?
See, these are my people. These are my people at Donington. I grew up listening to Ozzy and Kiss. The very first album I ever bought was a Kiss album, so.
We're kind of metal boys.
Yeah, I suspected that, actually.
Not me. No. Okay.
Old metal.
So but two-thirds metal.
ABBA and Adamant is where I'm coming from.
I go back to like...
Black Sabbath, Uriah Heep, that kind of stuff.
Now, that's cool, but Everclear, you guys have been around for a long time, and you just finally got platinum success with Sparkle and Fade. So, Art, for you, how does that feel to achieve success after a lot of very hard work? Does it make it even sweeter?
Yeah, but it just seems natural. I mean, I couldn't imagine it other way. Nothing comes easy for this band. Nothing. I mean, nothing just like, wow, we just got a great tour. I mean, we have to bite, kick, scratch, and just basically rip people's throats out to get where we're at. I mean, literally, we just work, we play.
And it's paid off?
I guess so. I mean, we don't really know because we're still on tour. I have no idea what's going on in the real world. I'm going to get home sooner or later.
Yeah, got to get back to the real world.
Yeah, okay. Oh, God. Yeah.
So, listen, how did you come up with your...
That reference? That was an Everclear reference. I see.
Quickly, how did you come up with the Everclear sound? Because, you know, you two guys are a bit metal. Was it just three guys coming together with some chemistry and some different influences?
I think so. I wrote all the songs. I come from a metal background, punk background, rock and roll background, basically, from Beatles, old country, old heavy metal, everything. It's just anything good that's emotional and that rocks has touched me. Even if it's just acoustic like Neil Young, I mean, I like it all. And these guys are coming from where they're coming from, and I think every record is starting to sound. We've got 25 new songs to record, and every record is sounding like Everclear, more like Everclear and less like our influences.
Excellent. And the lyrics, it seems you dug really, really deep. They're really life experiences, aren't they?
Yeah, I get really intense on my lyrics. That's what I like. I like singer-songwriters like John Prine and James Taylor. At the same time, I like bands like all the way from Led Zeppelin to the Sex Pistols.
And
everybody else.
Cool. Could I sum it up? The theme of the album, The American Dream, turned into The American Nightmare, maybe?
I think it's more American Nightmare turned into The American Dream.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Man, that's like profound. Yeah. That's...
So there's definitely a message of hope there.
I think it goes the other way, yeah.
Okay.
Well, the next record is We're All Going Downhill.
All right. Well, we want to finish on a positive note, so when can we expect to see you tour in Europe? We want to see you on a headline tour.
When the next record comes out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, lots of luck.
Thank you, Vanessa.
It's a pleasure talking to you, and I'm sure we'll be catching Everclear again when the next album comes out.
You're so much cooler and better looking than Ricky Rock.
Thank you very much. All right, we're going to check out Everclear live on stage. We've got some more live performance snippets for you. And actually, we're going to head off down to the second stage right now and see some of the highlights from the Kerrang stage, also featuring the likes of Typo Negative and Honeycrack and Three Colors Red. So a little highlights report now from the second stage. And Korn are coming up later. They rock. But right now, highlights from the second stage at Donington 96. Yeah! What you want me to be a partner in time and let the cover you. Yes, I'm breaking mad. If you're standing out loud, spinning out of myself. Cause I'm better, better now. I used to be. You were lying in bed and I would never turn. Better here, where we used to be. Wish I could go out into the orange sun. Just to live for the day. My legs would. I remember you, back in 83. You were crazy, insane, you were mine. You were different, I am on the ground. Black and black and black, still cool and casual. Better now, how we used to be. Always nervous and weird, scared most of the time. Better now, how we used to be. Always up in the night, breathing in the day. Ready to be his friend.
First time we've ever played a festival like this heavy. We normally play like Phoenix and Tina Park and indie festivals, but this was good. Good to get out there and play to people who like guitars.
Yep. Were the crowd ready to rock at that early hour?
Yeah, I was quite surprised actually. It was good, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We thought they wouldn't be awake, but
Live, which was your first single and did very well on as the biggest selling independent rock single of quite a while. What's your Hollywood? Is Donington your Hollywood? Or
No. I think you'll find that Hackney is our Hollywood.
Maybe your Hollywood, but it certainly isn't mine, mate.
Or Camden.
No, Camden isn't either. This is.
Or is it Hollywood? Maybe Hollywood's our Hollywood.
No, probably not. You're just confusing us now, Ben.
Oh, sorry.
Tell us a little bit about the message in the song.
It's just about being skint and just living life at its fullest and just having a good time, really. For me, it was. I mean, the lyrics were written by me and Pete, and the odd thing was written by everybody else. So. That was a song that we did the first time we ever got together in the studio. So everyone was like, the lyrics were there, but there was the odd line that wasn't quite right.
So everyone contributed to it. That song is everyone's.
But the original idea for it, the way I wrote it, was basically like being skint and just doing the best you can to have a good time.
So it's actually a really positive message.
Yeah, just
and
doing your best.
Do you feel that you know, the rock and roll, the entertainment value has gone out of rock and roll a little bit, and do you feel that you're one of the bands to put the rock and roll, the entertainment back into rock and roll? I know what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, I do as well. Definitely. I mean, we're trying to have a good time. We're trying to give everyone a good time, and we're just trying to write the best songs we can, and do the best we can at it. You know, on stage and stuff, and if people get into it, then brilliant. Great. If they don't, then fuck them. This is like Hollywood. I'll fuck the techno club. This is my
Hollywood. I ran out, wish I could. These aren't really ideal conditions for you because it's not really gloomy enough, is it?
No. We were expecting at least it to be overcast, but, well, the Lord works in mysterious ways.
So you'll be in bright sunshine.
And this way people can see just how ugly we are.
Well, I was going to say to see just how cool you look. Yeah. You look fantastic. So you're going to be playing My Girlfriend's Girlfriend live.
Are we?
Yeah, I think so. Is that the only song you're doing?
Are we?
New song.
Yeah, I think we are. Yeah, that's the only new song. We have a glorious half an hour on stage.
Right.
So we're going to play Christian Woman of Block number one, My Girlfriend's Girlfriend, Dodge Some Bottles, and then leave.
Oh, you've heard the rumors about the bottles then?
Oh, no, I haven't. Maybe you can tell me, so I know what to expect.
We have our own. We're filling them up right now, so
I'm all for cocktails. So.
Okay, yeah. Donington has a bit of a legendary reputation a few years back for throwing bottles and bits of meat and stuff on the stage, but I don't think that happens anymore.
Well, the meat I can handle.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that'll cut down on the food bills. But the bottles, maybe I could skip that.
So you're going to get in the mood with a glass of red wine and as you normally do?
Trying to hide it.
So just really, could you, the video for Girlfriend's Girlfriend, which we're playing at Headbangers Ball, very bright, very colourful, a very different video for Typo. Are you making a statement with that to show a different side of the band?
No, not really. We're just trying to reinforce the statement that you should always expect the unexpected from the band.
Yeah.
That whereas I would think most people would think that, you know, we're going to come out black and white, you know, gloom and doom with the old flashlight under the face type thing. Yeah. We came out with something totally different just to shock people.
Because I think that sometimes people don't really get the kind of irony and the sense of humor in Type O Negative.
They certainly don't. They don't.
I didn't think we had a sense of humor.
Headbangers Ball coming to you from Donington 96, kicking it here in the beautiful sunshine. And up next, it's Fear Factory making a welcome return to the show. So I've got Bert and Christiane with me
again.
Hello.
Hello again.
It's always good to see you guys.
Well, thanks, good to see you too, Vanessa.
Thank you. Now
I bump into you all over the place.
You probably think I'm a stalker or something.
No, I'm the stalker.
Well, let's get straight to the nitty gritty. You've been on stage. Actually, you're hot off stage, should we say. Now, it didn't exactly run smoothly, did it? What are your thoughts?
It was crazy. It started off a little strange. We didn't have our regular sound man, but I think he did a really good job. And during New Breed, like the power like just died on stage. Everybody's power just went, like someone blew a fuse or something.
It was a big snap. So we had like everything was gone.
Yeah. We had like 5 minutes on stage just with dead silence, and I had to like talk to the audience and stuff, and it was interesting. But we came back with Self-Bias Resistor and tore shit up.
You did. Well, I can guarantee. I can actually. Welcome back to Headbangers Ball, rocking backstage at the biggest metal event on the metal calendar, Donington 96. And right now we're hooking up with Dog Eat Dog. They're in the house at Donington, and I've got Dave and Brandon joining me here in the sunshine. So welcome down to Donington, guys. This is a fantastic achievement for you to end up on the bill here. What does it mean to you to be playing at Donington today?
Playing with Kiss.
Yeah, that's
Peter Chris, God of Thunder.
Yeah,
Dr. Love.
When we heard we were playing with Kiss and Ozzy, there was no question. I mean, we were actually on the Reading Festival too, but they said you have to pick one or the other, and it wasn't even a contest. Yeah, I mean, this is like, Brandon, I know, we got deep metal roots, of course, you know.
I know that.
This is like our way of like really showing everybody that, like, you know, we may be Dog Eat Dog now, but we love Kiss and Ozzy are two of the reasons that we're even playing the music we do now.
Brilliant. And actually, you have got quite a challenge today because you're going on between Biohazard and Sepultura, which are two pretty heaviest bands on the bill. How are you going to approach the show today?
As we usually do, set the tone. And get busy, as
but
usual.
Actually, we switched with Biohazard, so we're gonna go on before them. You know, this was like, you know, a sign of our friendship to those guys. I mean, they've given us so much over the past couple of years. I mean, a lot of the success that we've had, you know, comes from their giving to us. So we wanted to give them something back. So we were billed out above them. But as soon as we saw that, we said, you know, we're gonna switch with you guys and let you have it. It really doesn't make a difference to us whether we play now or then or anything. We're just happy to be here.
Excellent. And I think this the bill here today really shows how Donington has developed as a festival, because perhaps 5 or 6 years ago there wouldn't be a band like Dog Eat Dog on here. So you're definitely broadening it out.
We're happy to do it. Great. Yeah.
Now, you had so much success with the single No Fronts, and that was a case of that was the one song that everybody knew you for. But quite frankly, to me and whatever everything I've seen about you guys, you've actually proved that you're not just a one-hit wonder.
Yeah, I mean, we have a new record, Play Games, and we think every song on it is good and individual from each other. And, you know, we hope that we don't get just pigeonholed as a band with one hit and wonder or something like that, because that's not what we're about. We never even thought No Fronts was going to be a hit when we wrote it. We just wrote it like we write every other song. We got a lot more songs to come in the future.
Yep.
So we're going to just keep making music that we love, and we hope everybody likes it too.
Absolutely. And talking of new songs, you've got the new single Rocky due to come out, and that's actually you singing, Dave.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about the history of that song.
It was just one of those things, you know. I mean, I wrote it in a few minutes. It was just a joke, you know. It's about something personal within the band. So
personal?
Yeah, I mean, you know, and
we'll be right back.
well. That was Dog Eat Dog.
We'll be right back.
very tragic accident happened in Sepultura's family yesterday, and unfortunately Max has had to fly back to their hometown of Phoenix. And I think the best way to explain it is just to read you this press statement from Sepultura. On the morning of Friday the 16th of August, Dana Wells, Gloria Cavalera's eldest son, was killed in a road accident in Phoenix, Arizona. As a result, Gloria and Max Cavalera have had to fly home immediately. As a gesture to their fans, many of whom have made long journeys to see the band at Donington, the remaining members of Sepultura have agreed to play a short set, accompanied by some of their friends from the other acts appearing on the bill, and they're going to play for the same amount of time on stage that they were going to originally. And obviously we all appreciate that Sepultura will not be doing any press or interviews or promotion today whatsoever, and of course we want to respect their wishes, and just really our hearts go out to them at this very, very difficult time. And I'd personally like to say to Sepultura that I think that you guys are incredibly brave to go on stage as a three-piece and not let the fans down. With Headbangers Ball coming to you hard and heavy from Donington 96. And right now we're going to hook up with the band who headlined the second stage, the Kerrang stage here at Donington. It's Korn, and it's always a pleasure to see these guys. I've got Monkey and Jonathan joining me here. So welcome back down to the show, and of course to Europe, guys. You played a little earlier today. How was it headlining the second stage at Donington? What was the response?
I can't say nothing. I have no words to explain what I just saw there. I didn't have no clue it would be that intense. What do you think?
That sums it up.
That sums it up. It was incredible. Yeah. We had no clue. I went out there and just shocked the shit out of me, basically.
Yeah. Crowd was really
shocked. It was just intense.
Nice.
Very nice to us.
I can't imagine nice and kind of corn going in the same sentence, actually, but
that's our new vibe now. We're a nice band.
Good. Yeah. So what kind of stories did you heard about Donington before you came here? Were you aware that it's like probably the biggest metal festival in the world?
We have an itinerary booklet, and like it has the capacity for each place that we play, and then it says capacity, ?, big. So
we're pretty big, but not this big. It's the biggest event we've ever been to. It must be. I almost puked.
Excellent.
Well, here's Fieldy.
Fieldy, how are you?
And me.
Dog.
Oh, and Joe from Ozzy's band as well.
Field Dog's in the house now.
Excellent. So did the bagpipes come out today?
Yes. Did shoots and we did a cover. It's going to be on the new record, Lowrider.
Yeah. Okay, so we'd like to talk about the new album, actually. You finished recording it.
Yeah.
And what's it going to be called, and what can you tell us about it?
It's called Life is Peachy, and it's just better.
Yeah.
It's better. That's
it's
all
heavier,
I can explain it.
Fatter, it's all that, baby.
Is it even more menacing and psychotic than Korn?
Yes, it's a lot heavier. We all got better.
Yeah, well, that's understandable, because you just did touring and touring and touring, didn't you?
Yeah, basically we got tighter and we grew.
Why you guys want to try to go behind my back and get on TV without me?
Huh? Couldn't be on.
Hey, here comes another guy.
Come on, Head!
Run!
Head!
Well, I think we're going to end up with the whole band here in just a few moments. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll talk to the Korn guys some more in just a few moments, but we're going to check out Korn live on stage, headlining the second stage here at Donington 96. Let's see it now.
Look, I kept drinking, and as soon as I was drinking, it was clogging up. It's like very dusty there, you know.
Yeah, and also very, very hot. Did you have any problems with the actual heat?
Why do you think I was dunking my head in the water? A big, great big vat of water. I mean, it was, you know, I can't complain. As long as those kids had a good time, it's soul-chilling when they all start going nuts, you know.
Absolutely. Because you've just come off, you've broken off the American tour.
Yeah, but I'm going back because the wife's got a new shopping trolley and...
But how is it when you know you've got a totally extraordinary, massive show like that, even though you're doing shows every day, is it still something that's kind of lodged in your brain in advance?
No, it's kind of like... You know, it's a one-up event, so you want to make it special, and it's kind of like Murphy's Law, when you know what can go wrong does go wrong and will go wrong, you know. But you know, you go up there, you give it the best shot you can, and what we've done with this band is we have a motto: when you leave the stage, leave the gig on the stage. Don't go, you played the wrong note, you done.
Right, yeah.
It's over. You can't redo it, you know. And the band I have now is one of the nicest bunch of guys I've had.
Well, actually, I was going to say that because having seen the show in New York a couple of months ago and having seen a lot of incarnations of your band, I have to say that in terms of musicianship, energy and stage presence, the band you've got now is the best band you've ever had, don't you think?
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm not saying that the other guys were bad, I mean, but...
No, but the chemistry and the way it all works on this lineup.
I have fun. I mean, I always know when I got a good band when I don't have to look at the guitar player or look at the drummer for the next fill. I mean, or like on some occasions I've had some players where there's been a miserable member and I've been like trying to cheer him up while doing a gig to the audience and trying to make him laugh at the same time just to get the gig going, you know, so... I'm really happy with it, but at the same time, I mean, Mike's going to continue doing his Faith No More,
mm-hmm.
and Robert Trujillo wants to do his thing, and I encourage it. There's no reason why, like Genesis, they've got Mike and the Mechanics, they've got Phil Collins, but this unit is great. I first heard Michael Borden play when I had the opportunity to jam War Pigs at the Palladium years ago, and the first thing that struck me, I thought, man, that guy's phenomenal. I went straight on and I said, they've got a drummer from hell, man. And there's only one other drummer that I've ever heard hit like he does, and it's John Bonham.
I was gonna say John Bonham, yeah. Excellent.
Single kit, no frills, no electronic devices, he's a drummer.
Okay, well, we'll talk to Ozzy some more in just a few moments, but right now we are going to check out some live performance from yesterday at Donington 96 and watch out for drummer Mike Borden in action. Check it out.
Oh, Lord, I'm crazy!
relaxing here with Ozzy at home the day after Donington. And Ozzy, you last played Donington 10 years ago, in fact. And 10 years ago, it was a decade ago. And I don't know if you can answer this question, but 10 years ago, would you ever believe that you'd be coming back to co-headline 10 years later?
When I was asked to do the Donington show, it was a double headline thing. And when I last played Donington, I finished the show and the last person to end the show, I discovered the last time I played there, he thought he's not a very good spot because they're all thinking about getting to the car and getting out of there. He started to lose some of the crowd, and I said, yeah, sure, I'll do it, but I'll go on before Kiss. But I mean, I had a great time, and I must say, I thought Kiss played darn well. I was very, very, very surprised. They were really good.
Yeah, spectacular show it was, actually. And I wanted to ask you, what is your motivation to keep going? Because you're doing show after show, massive two years still on the road with Osmosis. So what's your motivation to keep going? Because I don't believe money for a start.
It's a passion. There's no sex, drugs or anything like rock and roll. I mean, the feeling, the emotion I get from, like, I would pay to see that, to get that emotion. Like, in other words, I want to feel the way I make them feel.
Yeah.
If that makes any sense.
I understand that. Yeah. It's a two-way thing.
I mean, I go to see them as much as they come to see me. And like, if there was an Ozzy Osbourne's spot where I would have to pay to go, I would pay money to go on there.
You know what, it's so great that you say that after you've been doing this for so long and you feel so passionate about it.
I'm no good at anything else. I don't even know how to turn the television on, you know, but when I'm on stage, I'm a different guy. I'm not that performer right now. I'm sitting in my little muddy cottage here in the country. I'm just, but put me on the stage and, I mean, the world can be on fire, but one of the other interviewers said to me, if you could choose a place anywhere when you're going to die, where would it be? And I said, on stage.
And you've worked very hard as well to get where you are. Let's not forget that. And just to finish, Ozzy, are you going to actually write with the band that you're with? I know you're doing a track for the Beavis and Butthead movie. Is that going to be with this band?
Oh, yeah.
Or how do you see the future?
The song's already written. It's called I Can't Walk on Water. It wasn't written, but with this band, one of my things from left over from the last lot of writing, and I love the song. But I certainly hope to. We did start writing some stuff in New York, but it was like in the middle of a tour. So what I'm planning on doing on this next leg is getting a time machine on sound checks, just getting little things going. Because Joe is always, he drives me nuts. He knocks my door. I said, Joe, if you knock my door with a Stratocaster again, I'll stick it up your rear end.
I've never seen him without a guitar.
I don't. He's like, when he goes to bed with his girlfriend, a guitar, and Joe. They'll never get babies. They'll be born with a wooden neck.
Fantastic. Well, lots of luck to you. I know you've got another grueling American tour to go back to.
It's not great. It's fun. Love.
And I'd like to wish you lots of luck with that, and also look after yourself.
Well, I always do.
Good, I'm pleased to hear it. That's Ozzy Osbourne. Thank you for having us down to your house today.
You're welcome.
Had a brilliant time. Cheers, Ozzy. And we'll just check out Ozzy live on stage at Donington 96 once again, another live performance for you. And after that, we're going to be bringing you an exclusive interview with Kiss. And we're going to be bringing you details of their upcoming European tour as well. So stay tuned. Kiss still to come, closing out our show here, Donington 96. But here's Ozzy live. We'll be right back. in town. Saturday at 11, Sunday at 6, and Wednesday at 12 on MTV. Bangers Ball, you've reached the final part of the show, and this is a true climax. We've got an exclusive interview with KISS for you, and I've got Paul and also Peter joining me here backstage at Donington, so it's lovely to see you guys.
Wonderful. And before we started shooting, I'm here to say that Vanessa did in fact climax. So this is truly a climax.
How can you tell?
How can I tell? Yeah. You were quaking.
I'm quaking because I'm so happy to see KISS back here, back in the UK, headlining Donington, the original lineup for the first time in 17 years, and I think that just says what a special occasion it is. So we're so happy to see you, but I know you've been asked this question a million times, but if you wouldn't mind answering to people in Europe, what was the reason that the original KISS lineup got back together? Why did you feel the time was right?
Well, you know, when we parted company, shall I say, we stopped believing in what we were doing. And we owe KISS fans 110% because they've always been with us 110%. And when we felt that we weren't doing a good job of living up to their expectations, it was clearly time for us to part company.
Right.
There were drugs, alcohol, egos, all kinds of things getting in the way. And until or if those could be cleared up, there was no reason for us ever to do this again. People have these fabulous memories of what we did in the past, and unless we could live up to them and surpass them, what would be the point in getting back together? Everybody's feeling real great, and part of the thing that is different today is everybody stopped pointing fingers at each other,
right,
blaming each other, and you look in the mirror and you say, you know, maybe I screwed up a little.
Great.
And that's what makes it good, and that's why we're here, and that's why we're starting to take the world over by storm. You know, we just finished America. We're in the midst of an American tour, and we played to 500,000 people in 30 shows. Most of the shows sell out in anywhere from 10 minutes to 20 minutes.
Yep.
70,000 people, 50,000 people. So it's been really great. Peter can tell you about, you know, the rest of the plan is world domination, and it starts today.
Absolutely. World domination starting here at Donington. But how is it to be headlining Donington here on this great day, this great lineup? How are you feeling?
I don't know if we're headlining. We're with Ozzy, so I wouldn't say we're headlining. We're both having a really good time together. I mean, but it's great. Like Paul said, we just did 31 concerts. That's a lot of concerts. So, you know, this is just another stepping stone for us only over here instead of America.
Absolutely.
Which is cool. Which is cool. Can I have your ring? Can I have the cat ring?
Oh yeah, I've got a little cat ring on actually, there you go. But what a point I'd like to get across to everybody in Europe, Paul, is that these shows are incredibly strenuous for you. You know, you've got back in all the costumes and everything, they weigh a ton, you're doing death-defying stunts and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
How did you prepare for this world tour?
A little of this,
yeah,
and a little of that. You know, we didn't take this lightly. People expected a lot from us, and there's nothing sadder than seeing a bunch of guys get back together who are either spilling out of their trousers or their hair doesn't seem to stay on. So, you know, we were very, you know, intent on making sure that this not only lived up to the past, but seemed to make time stand still.
Right.
You know, I mean, one of the greatest compliments we hear at the shows is that it's like we've been gone. It's like nothing's changed. It's kind of Dorian Gray syndrome. You know, we have those paintings in the closet that are rotting away. Magnificent.
But how was it to get back into the makeup? Was it just like getting back into a second skin?
Yeah, yeah. It was like getting into one of those favorite places you like to be in.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I know that well.
Warm,
so
warm and wet and comfy.
Say no more.
Thank you.
Bruce and Eric about this, and are you going to be releasing the album that you did with those guys as well?
Well, that, you know, that it's a bit of a dilemma, but Kiss is so strange in the sense that, you know, we break all kinds of rules. Here we are finishing an album with Eric and Bruce, an album that we felt really, really strongly about, and at the same time, it became obvious that now was the time for us to reform the original band. Mm-hmm. So, in light of that, we put this album on hold, one that we really believe in very strongly, and decided that it wasn't in that best interest of that album, or in the best interest of us today, to have the two out and coincide with each other. Right. So that album will stay. Album will stay wherever it is on the shelves for now. It's fabulous, but really we just want to make sure that today this is all that counts, and we're giving this 100%. Sure that this spreads the word through Europe and the rest of the world, as America already knows that this is real and that this isn't going away.
Absolutely.
And that we're coming to knock on your doors and then bang them down.
Absolutely. Well, very quick last question. You know, we've had the grunge thing in the early 90s. What do you think Kiss has got to offer the people, the kids that were into the grunge that didn't see Kiss first time around?
Well, you would just have to ask the people who are at the shows. You know, we've never been about trends or about fads, and music has all kinds of names. There's only two musics, actually.
Yeah.
And that's good music and bad music.
Or music you like or don't like.
Yeah, you know, or good or bad. But grunge, new wave, old wave, romance. You know, England has a way of coming up with all these categories for music, and most of them I just don't understand. You know, is it good or is it bad? There's some really horrid music being made that's called alternative,
right.
And there's some wonderful music being made that's called alternative. Conversely, there's some great music that's being made that's called metal, and there's some other stuff that's wretched. So what do the categories count? There's good and bad, and we're the best.
Fantastic. And European tour kicking off, I think,
November
the 20th. We'll show you the full dates at the end of the show if you want to check that out. Could you just leave us with a message for our viewers? What would you like to say?
I would just say that, you know, some things take a long time, and some things people wish for, and when they get the results of those wishes, they're not too happy. This is something you've been wishing for, and you're going to leave the show with a smile on your face, your ears ringing, and a lot of sweat on your brow.
That sums it all up. Well, thank you very much for taking time to talk to us on this busy day. Thank you, Peter, also.
Well, thank you.
Nice talking to you guys.
And as always.
We look forward to seeing the show tonight and see you in Europe in November.
Definitely.
All right, thanks very much, Paul. All the best. Cheers, guys.
Thank you.
That's it. We're going to check out some Kiss live on stage here at Donington 96. The costumes, the pyros, the special effects. It's a brilliant, brilliant show, sold out right across America. 4 sold out shows in Madison Square Garden in New York, selling out in record speed. So it's got to be good. Let's check it out. You wanted the best. You got the best. Kiss. I'm on the streets for a living. Coming up on Headbangers Ball next week, we are going to be out on
on the Pantera White Zombie US Tour, coming to you from Kalamazoo in the USA. And I'm very excited about next week's show because we've got a world exclusive interview with Phil Anselmo of Pantera. So stick around. Only 7 days to go to another great program. Pantera coming next week with that world exclusive interview with Phil. But from Donington, me and my friend here, we're signing off. I think he's had a good day. He's left his beer here. Maybe I can have a swig of this. But we're signing off. We'll see you next week on the Pantera Tour. Goodbye from Donington. Bye-bye.